Hey guys, it's Tanya with Cabco Moms. I'm here with Ashley today.
Hi.
She's returned to us. So we are at Vortex Bottle Shop in Harrisburg, and we are actually going to meet with one of my favorite lenders, David Tosillo with Fairway, and he's going to go over the steps you need to know and most frequently asked questions about getting pre-approved, which, as you know from the first video, is step one in home buying. So let's go in and we'll talk to him. So this is David Tosillo with Fairway Mortgage. Thank you for coming out today.
Sure, thanks for having me.
Yeah, so talk to us. Tell us what's the first thing you recommend if someone comes to you and says, I want to get pre-approved. Where do I start?
Yeah, the biggest thing I'd say is really just talk to a licensed professional. It's kind of like going to the doctor. You know, tell them what's unique about you. Tell them how you make money. Tell them about your credit. We're not the government, we're not the IRS, just tell us straight. You know, everyone's situation is a little bit different, but they can kind of, a licensed loan officer can really kind of lay out a plan and tell you kind of what your steps are. It doesn't cost anything. I'm not even paid until 5 or 6 weeks after the loan closes. So just be upfront, be honest, tell them how you make money, tell them about your credit, and then kind of get the ball rolling that way.
So that being said, what credit score do you look for?
So good question. So we'll pull three different scores. We're going to throw out the high number. We're going to throw out the low number. Most lenders will take that middle number. So it's not an average. Usually most lenders, it's 2022, most lenders are probably looking for about a 600 or higher. If you can get above 640, there's a lot more like first-time homebuyer programs and other options that might be opening up. Obviously, the better your credit is, the more options and the better rates and stuff that you have, but 600 is kind of the rough idea of what we're looking for.
So I did have a good question the other day.
Sure.
Someone asked me, they have good credit scores, but would you recommend paying down credit card debt and having less for a down payment, or waiting to pay off that credit card, not paying as much and having more of a down payment?
So good question. Depends on scenario. Some people have to pay down debt in order to qualify. Other people, we actually tell them, hey, it might be better to hold that money for the down payment. You also might need to be buying a new lawnmower or curtains or something like that. So a lot of times, talk to your loan officer to see. We'll guide you and recommend it. But no, very few people have zero debt. We get that. You know, it's just a matter of making it look as pretty as possible. It doesn't have to be flawless, you know, and realistically, even if your credit scores go up 20 points, you're maybe going to save $11 a month on your payment, you know. So generally speaking, it might be better to keep that money on hand and save for your down payment, but we can kind of guide you through that as well.
Awesome. All right, good. And another question for you. So I have a friend, her husband is in the process of becoming a citizen.
Okay.
She is a citizen, but does not currently have a full-time job.
Okay.
How do you recommend she goes about that situation?
So, good question. So, obviously, one of the biggest things to qualify for a loan is your ability to repay the loan. Do you have income? Do you have a paper trail that we can document that looks like you've made money, that looks like you can repay the loan? Citizenship is an issue. There's different loan programs and different things we could talk about. Generally speaking, the green card would kind of open up a lot more doors for that individual, but there's definitely other options that they have that they could talk to someone about. So I would say maybe there's a chance. We don't know for sure until we really dive into it, but it's not something that scares me. It's not something that I would, you know, turn and run away from. So.
And then leave us with your last tips. What are the top three things you want people to know?
Top three things. No one is ever really ready to buy a house. You don't really know what you know until you start the process. It can be crazy and it seems like a lot, but there's a lot of people in this world that have bought a house, and I'm sure you can too. Just ask some questions. Just get the ball rolling. Plan ahead. We don't want you to buy a house because your lease is up in 2 weeks and you don't have a plan. You just got to find something. It's the biggest investment you're probably ever going to make, but it's also the biggest debt you're ever going to take on. So just do a little bit of legwork. Save a little bit of money if you can. Your credit doesn't have to be perfect. Just ask questions and be open with your loan officer, and they'll kind of lay out a plan custom for you. So.
Yes, I find that people are often so nervous to get that pre-approval started. But once you take that first step, people like David make it easy and as painless as possible.
I'm here to help. If you guys need anything at all, I'd be more than happy to. I'll make sure I include my contact information in the end. Tanya's amazing as well. She handles everything related to the house, the building that you're buying. I'm the dorky guy behind the calculator. So if we can help, let us know. But it's no pressure, no obligation. Just ask questions and let's get the ball started. So.
Thanks, David.
Yep, sure thing.